Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Gagik. Imagine after driving a couple of hours to your favorite camping destination, now all you want to do is to relax and enjoy your trip. But then you still need to set up your tent, unload all your camping gear, and set up the kitchen. And as you know, that's very time consuming, and it's not fun. I used to have the same problem with my previous setup. That's the reason I came up with this new setup. With this setup, all I need is 30 seconds, and I'm ready to camp. Let me show you guys how. Probably not even 30 seconds, and I'm ready to camp. Now, you might say I still need to unload my kitchen stuff and all the camping gear, but that's not the case anymore because everything is set up inside, ready to go, just like an RV. So before I show you guys inside the camper, I'd like to talk about the camper itself. This is a wedge style camper made by Topo Toppers. They're based here in California, Ventura County. The owners are Thomas and Katie, and they're a really nice couple. Imagine after I placed my order, it took them only 40 days to finish and install the camper on my truck. As you guys know, some similar companies lead time is about like 12 months. I've done some modification as far as the locking mechanism and some of other stuff inside, which I'm gonna talk about it in some other video. But as far as the quality, I'm super happy about the quality. I camp in Yosemite under heavy rain for 3 straight days and not even a single drop of rain got inside the camper. So if you guys are looking for a high quality camper, please check out Topo Toppers. Now let me show you guys inside. This is how the inside looks when the bed is flat and I'm ready to sleep. As you can see, I have my kitchen here. I have my toilet, I have my fridge, and everything is basically set up inside. The way to get your bed is through this opening, which is about 17 inches. So that's the way you crawl up and to your bed. So here is the top level where I sleep, and I have my pillows over there, I have my blanket, I have this really nice 2-inch high density foam mattress which comes with the topper. I have windows on each side, I have these pockets as well, and this is the opening I was talking about. Basically, this is the way you get to your bed. Now, the original Topo Toppers bed platform comes in 2 pieces. And let's say if you want to stand up here, as you can see now, there is not enough headroom. So what you can do is you can stack those platforms on top of each other, then fold the mattress on top of the platforms. That way you're not gonna have this platform over here anymore. So you can have all this headroom. You can stand up here and do whatever you want. Well, I asked them to make my bed platform in 1 piece only, and the reason behind it, first of all, I wanted to have this storage space underneath, and I wanted to be able to lift the platform in 45 degree angle versus stacking them on top of each other. That way I would still have the same amount of headroom, but it would take me much less time to do that versus stacking the platforms on top of each other and then fold the mattress. Now, let me show you guys how easy it is to put away the bed. As easy as that. Now I have full access to my kitchen. I can cook and do whatever I want. And let's say if I'm ready to sleep, all I need to do is... and done. This is how the inside looks like with the bed all the way up. As I said, I wanted the platform to be in 1 piece so I can have this storage space over here on the bed platform. I have my smoke and CO2 detector, obviously because I'm cooking inside. I have my gun holster and cleaning kit over here. I have a hammock, I have an outdoor blanket, I have some Windex, Clorox wipe, and Lysol for the toilet, and I have my camping towel over here, as well as paper towel holder some sponges, and of course fire extinguisher. Here I am sitting inside the camper with the bed all the way up, and this is where my kitchen is. I have my stove, I have my sink, and I have all these cabinets over here, which I'm going to show you guys in a minute. So right here on the top I have my cutting board. I have my 110 power outlet, which is connected to my Jackery 1000 Pro battery. I have a map light over here with a USB charging port for my cell phone. I have the switch for my hardcore lighting over there. This is tricolor lighting. It's a great little light. Right over here, I have my iPad stand, and I can basically slide the iPad inside there, and I can watch movies if I want to. Now, I'm not a fan of listening to music, but I have this Bluetooth speaker over here, and I connect it to my iPad whenever I want to watch, let's say, YouTube or movies inside the camper. In this first drawer, I keep my kitchen knives, all my spices, spatulas, and everything that I might need for cooking. So in this second drawer, I keep my pan and pots, my kettle, my French press coffee maker, but I also use this drawer as a base or stand for my kitchen table. So what I have over here is a piece of wood which I can basically put on the top of the drawer just like that, and now as you see I have a kitchen table over here, or a table that I can work or do whatever I want. In this next drawer I have some more kitchen stuff, such as my grater. I have some collapsible bowls over here. I have aluminum foil, I have some Ziplocs, and I have this mini 110 volt mixer. The next drawer is pretty obvious. This is where I keep my first aid kit. And by first aid kit, I mean I have pretty much everything in this drawer. I have a blood pressure monitor, I have oxygen monitor, I have my tourniquet, I have all sort of medication that I might need while I'm camping. Now you might say this is way too much, but I'm doing a lot of camping and off-roading in the middle of nowhere, so I just want to be prepared in the case of emergency. And in this last drawer is where I keep all my tools, just in case I need to fix my truck. Back to the top section again, this is where I have my Primus stove. This is made in Sweden, and I absolutely love this stove, and the reason why is I can easily remove these pieces from here, wash them, clean them, and then put it back together, and looks like brand new again. This top cabinet is where my pantry is. This is where I keep some extra food, olive oil, lemon juice, tea, coffee, tomato paste, and everything that I might need for cooking. The next cabinet is where I keep some plastic utensils, paper plate, paper bowl, and my coffee and teacups. Now in this section I have my Jackery 1000 Pro battery. Now, as you can see, I have the old version Jackery 500 as well. I'm using the 500 mainly for my Chinese diesel heater during winter time camping, and the reason why I got the 1000 is now I have more LEDs to cover, so I needed more power. Also, what I love about the 1000 Pro is I can charge it in under 2 hours, versus the 500 is, I believe, almost 6 hours. Moving back to the top part, this is where I have my sink. I'm using these two water dispensers as my faucets. These have pump inside, which you can charge them with a mini USB, and I connected the gray one to my 13 gallons water tank, which is a tap water, and the white one is connected to my 10 liters drinking water, and we push up a button and I have water which I can wash my hands or dishes if I have to. Same thing with the drinking water. Right in the center I have my soap dispenser. Now, right underneath the sink, I have my Renogy 1000 watt power inverter. I'm using it to charge my Jackery 1000 Pro battery. I also have my propane tank over here, as well as the drinking water tank. I connected this quick disconnect to my water tank. And the reason why is whenever I want to fill it up or clean the tank, I can easily disconnect it from here and take it outside, fill it up, and then put it back. In this small drawer, I keep all my personal hygiene stuff. And then this is my 13 gallons tap water tank. As you can see, there's this hose that goes towards outside the camper. And I have a water inlet mounted on the body of the camper so I can fill up the tank from outside with a garden hose easily. I also have this opening over here, which is for ventilation and for using my camping shower kit. So this is where my toilet is. Now, the only reason I wanted the toilet inside the camper is for one of those rainy or cold nights when I don't want to leave the camper, I can use the toilet here. I'm using my camping shower kit as flushing system for the toilet. And the way this works is the pump goes inside the tank and I can turn on the pump from here. That's rechargeable, by the way. And then I can basically use that as flushing system or as a bidet to wash myself if I have to. And probably you guys are wondering where the water goes. I drilled a hole on my truck bed, so basically that's where the water goes. I forgot to mention that whenever I want to, I can remove the toilet while camping for, let's say, extra space if I want to. And if I'm not using the toilet, it's just an extra comfortable seat for me to sit on. Right behind the water tank, I have some garbage bags. I also have the plastic bags for the toilet. So just like any other camping toilet, I can put the plastic bag on the top of the toilet and use it like that if I want to. I have some wet wipes over here, and I have my propane heater over here. I use this as a backup just in case my Chinese diesel heater doesn't work. Right over in this section is where I keep some of my camping gear, such as my foldable camping shovel, some bungee cords, camping saw, and some other stuff, which I'm gonna go through them in a different video. Over here I have a seat, which is also my closet. Inside I have my emergency blanket slash tarp. I highly recommend to have one of these inside your truck. Next, I have my foldable surviving rifle. This is a Kel-Tec model SU-16, 5.56 caliber. As you can see, you can store the magazines inside the stock. These are 10 rounds each magazine. I'll probably do a review for the rifle later. Next, I have my backpack, which I have all my surviving gear inside, such as shelter, paracord, fire starting kit, water filtration system. So in case of emergency, I can just grab the backpack and the rifle and I'm good to go. Next is my bag over here, which I have extra pants, extra shirt, extra socks, you name it, inside there. And last is my gun belt. Over here I have my 12 volt Dometic CFX35 fridge slash freezer. Now I don't have much stuff in it today because I'm not camping overnight. I just came here for the video, for the day. Other than that, I can store a lot of food in here if I need to. On this side I also have a map light with a USB port. I have the thermostat for my Chinese diesel heater. I have the vent for the heater and my Streamlight flashlight. So if you guys remember, I said I do a lot of solo overlanding, off-roading and camping in the middle of nowhere. And I want to make sure I'm gonna go back to my family safe every single time.
So I have this beautiful American flag wall art over here, which has a storage space inside. And inside, I keep some of my favorite things over here, such as my 12 gauge shotgun. That's a Mossberg 930 SPX. I have some bird shots, I have some bug shots, I have some slugs, I have my Grand Force camping axe, some bear spray, I have my limited edition BK-77. Now, this is by KA Bar. This is not your regular BK-7. I believe they only made 185 of these. And right over here, I have my 10 millimeter Glock 20 handgun.
That's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. In the next video, I'm going to talk about the truck itself and all the camping and off-roading gear that I have inside the truck. So please don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video. You can also follow me on Instagram at noroad_noproblem. But until then, explore, be safe, and don't forget to enjoy life.